Right, hello YouTube. So, on the April, on the 8th of April, 2014, you may be you may know that Windows XP is going out of support, and that might be a problem for you since you might have older computers like this Pentium 4 over here that run Windows XP. So, you know, this is a 3.2 gigahertz Northwood P4 with a gig of RAM and a Radeon 9600 XT. It's one of the more powerful P4 machines of the time, but anyways, you might, you know, have, say, an old Pentium 4 or an old, say, Pentium M laptop, or an old Windows XP-based machine, and, you know, and you might still want to get some use out of it. Or you may know people who have these older machines that can't upgrade their computers. Well, there is an operating system for this. And it's called Windows Embedded POSReady 2009. Now what it is a version of Windows XP that you can download it's a version of Windows XP that's pretty much stripped down, and POS means it means point of sale. So it's, you know, meant for, say, like cash registers and ATMs and stuff like that. But you can download this from Microsoft as a 60-day evaluation for it, and as long as you have the right key, then you can, you know, use this. So you can download this OS. It's pretty much just a very light and stripped down version of Windows XP, and it runs fantastic on these older computers. And you know, these computers, you know, they may not be able to run Windows 7. For example, my ThinkPad R51. That I got from Elmol 3. That thing has a Pentium M 1.6 and 2 gigs of RAM. That thing can barely run Windows 7, so. And POSReady 2009 is like the perfect OS for it, since XP runs kind of slow too, and that's also going out of support. What's good about POSReady 2009 is, you know, it's stripped down, like I said before, and it has support until 2019. So that is excellent, actually. So, you can download it free from the Microsoft website. It's a 60-day trial. And, yeah. So what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be installing it and giving you a tour of the OS. So I have it on this blank disk. Oh, it's not blank anymore, but I have it on this disk. I'm going to install it on my Pentium 4 custom build. I do have it installed on the R51, this R51. The one that Elmo 3 gave me. I do have it installed in there, and it runs very well. So let's try it on this Pentium 4 custom build. I haven't installed it yet. This has got a blank hard drive. So let's turn on the machine. You can see me. And let me get the keyboard out. There we go, it's going to boot into the CD. And we'll be right back when it's booted up. Before we continue, I'm going to apologize about the refresh rate. I am using a CRT monitor in this setup, so. Alright, so here is the setup for Windows Embedded POSReady 2009. Again, there's nothing I can really do about the refresh rate. Or if there is, I don't know how to work this fucking camera. But anyways, so it looks quite a bit different from Windows XP, and you'll see that this setup is quite a bit different. So let's click Next. It'll ask you if you want a standard or unattended setup. So that's one of the differences. Unattended setup, you know, means that you can create a file with all the settings, and then say if you want to install it on a fleet of machines, you can. So, you know, that's good for that, so you don't have to, you know, fiddle around with settings on every machine. Alright, so we're going to insert your product key. I'll be right back with that. Alright, so I fixed the refresh rate. All I have to do is turn off steady shot on my camera. So if the video appears a little bit shaky than usual, then I apologize. So, anyways, so once you enter your product key, you click accept license agreement, then next. Now you enter your name and organization, so I'll just do that. Let me put the camera down. Okay, click next. Alright, now you can either install third-party storage drivers or not. I'm not going to since I don't need to. Like, that'd be for, like, say, a system with a RAID controller or something, maybe. It's a very nice setup. I do like it. So you may have seen Elmo3's video and maybe VideoSum Frontier's video on this operating system. So now, unpartition space, we create a partition. Create the size of the partition. I want to use the whole drive. This is a 120 gigabyte drive. There we go, partition's created. So we select the partition, we click next. Now we want to format a drive. So this may look familiar if you've formatted a flash drive or a floppy disk or something like that. So we choose the file system. I want NTFS, allocation size, default volume label. I want Windows Embedded. Drive. You can choose your drive letter, so I'm going to leave it on C. You can perform a quick format and enable file and folder compression, which I'm not going to do. So next, now it's going to format a drive. There we go, drive's formatted. If you don't choose a quick format, that'll probably take longer. Alright, choose your country and region. I'm not in the United States. English, Australia, and this is the language for applications. English, Australia. Install third-party language packs, which I'm going to do just because I want to increase the size as much as possible. See how big I can get it. Right, choose your country. So I'm not in the US. A time zone. Let's see, I'm in Canberra, Melbourne, Sydney. And then that's already got correct for standard formats. Next, you can choose your size. I'm going to choose custom. Now there's one thing that you have to install with this if you want to install some programs. That's update root certificates. You have to install that if you want to install some programs like the Opera web browser. Which for these older systems is fantastic. So I'm going to choose Windows Media Player. I'm going to install everything but the touchscreen keyboard. Because that does get in the way and it does get annoying. So, and I don't need it because this is obviously not a touchscreen. If it is, that's a pretty fucking thick CRT touchscreen. Anyways, so install everything. Accessories, utilities, you have like, you can choose like Notepad and stuff like that, additional drivers, but you can choose anything you want, but make sure you install update root certificates, because you need that to install some programs. So the total size is going to be just over a gigabyte in size, which is pretty good. I've seen it go down to like 900 megs before, or 800 megs. You can get this, you know, pretty small. So, but this system has a 120 gig drive, so I'm not worried. Alright, so click next. Alright, now this is your virtual memory, your paging file. I would leave this by default, unless if you know what you're doing with it. I'm going to leave it as default since I really don't know much about virtual memory. Right, choose your computer name. This one is my 2005 custom build, so I'm going to name it ...2005CB. And now you have to put an administrator password. It has to be a secure password too, so that means it has to have at least one capital letter and one number, so I'm going to put mine in. You can remove it later if you want. Right, there we go. These options for IP addresses and stuff I'm going to leave blank. Choose your work group, or you can join a domain, which is good for a fleet of machines. You know, if you say you got, you know, a bunch of point of sale systems that obviously are not going to be connected to the internet, but they're going to be connected to a local network. So you can join a domain like that, a Active Directory domain. Or if you even have just a standard Windows server, you can do it. Which I actually do have a Windows server. Anyways, I'm not connecting to them with domain though, so I'll just leave it as work group. And there we go, there is all the settings, so you can have a look through and see what you're going to install.
and then click install.
And there we go. It does take quite a bit to install, so I will come back when it is installed, so I will see you then. And unlike Windows XP, it doesn't say 39 minutes for, like, you know, 40, it doesn't say 39 minutes for, like, you know, 10 minutes of installing. Anyways, I'll be back. Alright, so it just rebooted. It's rebooted several times already, but I think this is the final time, so that needs to restart. So we're not going to boot from the CD. Oh, excuse me. Anyways, so you can clearly tell it is based off of Windows XP. I forgot to mention this OS will run pretty much anything that Windows XP can run, as long as you install the updated root certificates. So this is what most of the installation process has looked like through the past couple of reboots. So it does take quite a bit to install. I think it's like the fourth time it's rebooted so far now. But I think it's nearly done. So. So I will get back to you when it actually is done. Alright, so we're finally in. It just rebooted and finished up installing, so the username and password it gives you is administrator, so it's hard typing with one hand. And put the password you put in during setup, so there we go. So it uses the Windows, the classic style login that you might recognize from Windows 2000. So you can see we have a new wallpaper and we do have the embedded theme. So this might look familiar to you during setup. And there we go. You can see we have a new theme, the embedded theme, which is pretty much, it's based on the Royale, the Media Center theme, but it's pretty much all blue. So, and there we go. You can see the Windows XP style start menu and the taskbar. So there we go, we have a custom background saying Windows Embedded POSReady 2009. Of course, saying that we have no antivirus, so we can tell it is Windows XP. If I go into my computer, you can see clearly it is Windows XP system properties. So we have Windows Embedded POSReady 2009, registered to me. So the specs, this particular machine has a 3.2 GHz Intel Pentium 4 and a gigabyte of RAM. So, wonder if it detected my GPU out of the box. It did. Radeon 9600 family. This is a 9600 XT, so we can up the resolution to, don't want that high. 1024x768, that's what this monitor goes up to. Oh, it goes higher than that, but that's what this monitor supports. You can see we don't have video tearing, so drivers are installed, release for the video. Let's go into, let's go, no, I don't want to rename it, I want to go properties. Let's go device manager. So the only thing we have to install is the sound card driver, so I'll get my drivers installed and I will be right back. So, all the drivers are installed now, so let me just eject my driver disk. I know I should use the latest drivers, but this system's old, so they're probably just as outdated as the disk anyways. So, anyway, so let's have a look around this OS. So it looks like XP. Go into the start menu, say there's not much. We have my computer, my network places, control panel, printers and faxes, and run. If we go into all programs, you can see how abysmal it is. You can see we don't really have much. I installed everything that you could except for the touchscreen keyboard. Anyways, so you get accessibility, communication, system tools. In accessibility, I did put the accessibility tool since I need the big mouse cursors, so I need the accessibility installed. Communications, you get, you get, you know, your standard magnifier, narrator, and everything.
in communications, you get faxing services, hyperterminal, and network connections, and the new connection wizard. System tools, you get NT backup, character map. This comes with Internet Explorer 7, Security Center, system info, and system restore. You get the calculator, clipboard viewer, notepad, paint, remote desktop, Windows Explorer, and WordPad. So you get your basic stuff. That's my sound driver. Startup is nothing. Get IE7, Remote Assistant, and Windows Media Player 11. So, you know, IE is just Internet Explorer 7. I am connected to the internet with this machine, so. But you can see it is IE7. You can update this to IE8, and I recommend that you do that, just so you get Windows Update to work. Because you do need Internet Explorer 8, but you do have a choice of any browser that support that will run on Windows XP, so you can run Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera. I recommend Opera on these older computers because it runs fantastically well. So, and Windows Media Player is Windows Media Player 11. So let's go Express, Finish, and it is Windows Media Player 11. Let's go Show Menus since I like it like this. So, we see Media Player 11. You can see the sound is working. So I got my sound to work. Everything is working. This already had my video driver installed. Let's go remove from this list. You notice that you did, in the control panel, you get all your settings, including, you know, this category view layout. Let's go to classic. Get all your settings that you usually get. You can also bring back the welcome screen. So, you know, the classic welcome screen from XP. So if you go change the way users log on and off, you have to disable offline files to do that. You go change the way users log on and off, and you can enable the welcome screen. I'm not going to do that since I don't like the welcome screen, but your user account, you can change the picture. Now, personally, if you're going to use this as an actual, like, you know, OS, I would recommend creating a new user account instead of using the administrator account. So, just create a new account because I don't know, that's just the way I like to do things. I don't really like using the admin account for personal use. So, but, you know, just how much space it takes up. I haven't installed anything except for my drivers. So, see, it is 2.87 gigabytes. But I have plenty of space. But yeah, that is. Let's see, what else is there in it? There's not really much in this OS, but you can install anything that you want, really. Just go WINVER. You can see build 2600 Service Pack 3, so you can tell it is Windows XP. If you haven't already noticed. But, you know, you can see the new banner there to match the background. Well, not match the background, but, you know. I like this theme, and it, you know, it's a nice theme that they've gone with, the blue. Like how the start menu lights up, you know, blue when you go over it, so. Anyway, so that has been Windows Embedded POSReady 2009. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next video, so have a good day.